industry first to launch the new Actros. We are doing a live stream drive day. This is all live, so it's all happening now. Andrew, should we go inside the truck?
Let's get in the truck.
All right, here we go. So, let's open this beautiful rig up. So why don't we start from the start? You talked about the key out the front. We've done the key check.
Yes.
That is a keyless start. So Rob just pushed the engine start button and we're away.
Correct. So simple as having the key in your pocket, put on the brake, press the start, stop button, the vehicle will start. So it just makes it a little bit easier to one less thing to think of about putting the key in the ignition barrel to get the vehicle up and running.
But we'll get to the screens in a second, but the actual design of the interior is made for comfort.
Yes.
And for efficiency, right?
Absolutely right. And from a comfort perspective, it's even really well thought out in the way that it's laid out to you. So everything's easy to reach for. You can see even looking in Rob's seating position, everything on the driver's side is black for... so it can be a bit more robust for people getting in and out. And on the passenger side, where we want a little bit more space, it's a little different colour here as well, just to give the feeling and the impression of space. The other big part of comfort, though, as well, of course, for Rob, is the seat that he's sitting in, Shura. So it is one of the most adjustable seats available, air-suspended seats that we can offer the market.
Can we use that beautiful word, ergonomic?
Absolutely. It is super ergonomic, and also the armrests, even massaging functions and lumbar supporting.
And as we can see, there are lots of screens.
So, as you rightly said, there's four digital displays in this vehicle. So the two on the A pillars that we can see here are our mirror cameras. The other two screens are that we see in front of you is the digital instrument cluster, so which can be adjusted through the steering wheel. So all the key features that Rob needs to see for his drive in terms of speed, tachograph, fill information for fuel, AdBlue, and also coolant levels, anything that might be important to him, is available to him through that dash and can be customised to his liking.
Trucks weren't normally known to have this sort of style and comfort that the Actros has, do they?
No, and it's a big change. So this whole multimedia cockpit and layout has been really well thought out to try and support the driver and make it as comfortable as it can be for him. So, yes, it's a big step up, of course, and the multimedia cockpit design itself gives a lot more perception of space, even for the driver, by taking away the sides of that traditional instrument cluster that would have sat in front of Rod, but giving him really crisp information.
What about navigation systems for the truck?
So that's also included as part of this multimedia cockpit. So the second display screen here, which is a multi-touch display, includes navigation. So truck mapping and navigation.
So the functionality is huge. I mean, this is part of it. Yeah. We're trying to make as easy as possible for the driver.
Correct.
And the efficiency as good as possible.
That's right, absolutely. So ease for the driver, as efficient as possible. And it's also important to note that while this is a touch screen, we do have the soft switches and combination of soft and hard switching, so you can still have a choice, right? And everything can be done still from the steering wheel. So when we look over to Rob, where his hands are at the moment in the steering wheel, both on the left-hand side and the right-hand side of the steering wheel, there is a navigation button. So he doesn't have to be touching the screen. He can just keep his eyes on the road.
Now, one of the things that this truck has, I can see in front of me, is a charging port.
Correct. Yeah, that's right, Shura. So we've got two mechanisms of charging, but what we include in this vehicle here is a inductive charging system. So simply place our phone here and it will be connected to the charger. So if your phone's capable of inductive charging or wireless charging, all you need to do is place your vehicle on the charging mat and it will be charged through that
mechanism. So you can do it on the charging mat, or you've got USB-C?
Or we have USB-C. So if we're able to see on over my side, there's a USB-C connection, which is our standard in this vehicle now to give us the highest level of connectivity to the vehicle and fastest data transfer.
Yep. Sound system?
Yeah, absolutely. So we've improved this as a premium sound system in this vehicle as well. And of course, we've got Apple Play. Once we're connected through USB-C to an appropriate phone or device, we can have CarPlay available to us in this system, which is all controllable.
I just want you to know, and this is for Rob's benefit, this was the song that I was going to play, Rob, that I thought was pretty applicable.
Is we have both dual band Bluetooth in this vehicle as well. So what I mean by that is we can connect two different devices, because as a driver you might have a company phone for one reason and you might have your personal phone. Right. So I do have the flexibility to connect two devices and use that as part of the total system.
We should also talk about the fact that mentioned it off the top when we took our jackets off, but the climate inside here is beautiful, so it's obviously got to be easy for the driver as well to control the climate.
That's right. So we've got automatic climate control, but adjustable as well, which again can be operated through that multi-touch touch display, and that's one of the buttons we can see there right now. So simply by touching that display, I've got full control over the climate system, or I can just simply flick a door down and set the temperature, sure, and just make it really simple.
There are other things, obviously central locking system, correct. That's important.
Yeah, correct. So that's included in every vehicle. So central locking is part of what we offer, so easy to open the vehicle from remote and either side as well.
It's quiet inside here as well, should I mention that?
It is very quiet inside this, and that it is a really quiet vehicle. So, I mean, we're sitting here beside each other talking quite comfortably, sure, and that's part of the design of the vehicle as well, and part of what we're trying to achieve to give more comfort.